Hello guys, this is Indian Medico, and in this video, we are going to see about torticollis. This is a concise presentation for medical students. Torticollis is also known as wry neck. Now let us break the term torticollis. Tortus literally means twisted. Collum literally means neck. So torticollis literally means twisted neck. The term wry also means twisted. Torticollis is a rare condition in which the neck muscles contract, causing the head to twist to one side. It is basically a deformity of neck where head and neck are turned and twisted to one side. Torticollis can be permanent or temporary or spasmodic. Spasmodic torticollis is the most common type of torticollis. This picture shows a patient with torticollis. As you can see, the head and neck are twisted to one side. Now let us see about the causes of torticollis. Torticollis can be congenital. It is basically due to sternocleidomastoid tumor. We'll be seeing about congenital torticollis in detail in the upcoming slides. Infections can lead to torticollis. Examples include tonsillitis, atlantoaxial infections. Torticollis can be due to reflex spasm in case of acute cervical disc prolapse. Torticollis can be due to neurogenic causes like spasmodic conditions and paralytic conditions. Torticollis can be due to ocular causes. That is, torticollis can result as a compensation for squint. Other causes of torticollis include rheumatoid arthritis and spasmodic torticollis. Mostly, torticollis is secondary to pain as a result of reflex muscle spasm. In these cases, the torticollis recovers once the inflammatory process subsides. Now let us see about congenital torticollis. Coming to the pathogenesis of congenital torticollis, in case of congenital torticollis, there will be a sternocleidomastoid tumor, which is basically a lump on one side in the first few weeks of life. This lump disappears spontaneously. But the problem is, the sternocleidomastoid tumor causes fibrosis of the sternocleidomastoid on the affected side. This fibrosis is due to ischemic necrosis. As a result of fibrosis, the fibrosed sternocleidomastoid fails to elongate, leading to torticollis. It is more common in children with breech presentation. This picture demonstrates the features of congenital torticollis. The head will be tilted towards the affected muscle. The chin points away from the contracted muscle, and prominent contracted sternocleidomastoid can be seen. Now let us see about the diagnosis of congenital torticollis. The child usually presents at 3 to 4 years of age. The head is tilted to one side, as you can see in the figure. The chin faces the opposite side. Prominent sternocleidomastoid can be seen on the side the head tilts. There will be increased prominence on trying to passively correct the head tilt. When the child presents in the first few weeks of life, a lump can be made out in the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Facial asymmetry can be there when the child presents later in life. Radiology will usually be normal. Radiology is done to rule out any underlying bone defect like scoliosis, which is nothing but sideways curvature of spine, which can mimic torticollis. How do you treat a case of congenital torticollis? When the child presents in the first few weeks of life with a sternocleidomastoid tumor, or when the child presents with mild deformities, passive stretching and splinting can help prevent severe deformities. When the child has already developed severe deformity, a release of contracted sternocleidomastoid is done. The release can be done either in the lower attachment or both attachments of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. After surgery, calyoid cast is used to maintain neck in the corrected position. This picture shows a child who has been operated for congenital torticollis and is currently wearing a calotte cast. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in this comment section. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe, and tell your friends about this channel. Thank you.